So Mark, what's exciting about Roundtrip is that you have this unique expertise background in the ambulance business, and now you've positioned this business to improve outcomes for folks with who are using transportation services and improve healthcare outcomes. How do you see healthcare and paratransit intersecting, or transportation writ large intersecting?
Yeah, it's pretty fascinating because they're more similar than not, the more that we think about it, right? So we've got healthcare, which is largely shifted into outcomes-based, and even further down the pathway to social determinants of health. How do we address the reasons that folks are not getting access to healthcare, or that folks are routinely coming into an ER? Well, maybe they didn't have access to food or clothing, shelter, the basic necessities. And then we look at even the traditional paratransit and public transit space, where it was about mobility in terms of access, but the destination for people really is, again, food, clothing, shelter, work, the things that allow them to contribute to society. So through one lens, there's an overlap here and an alignment of focus, healthcare on outcomes, paratransit on destination. That kind of makes a lot of sense. I think through another lens, there's also an ability to maybe bring the two together. So we've got a whole network of paratransit. We've got a whole network of non-emergency medical transportation. And the rider, the beneficiary, might actually be able to access both programs depending on their mobility and their profile of need. Can we bring together these networks? Can we start using some of the resources in one to augment the other? And I think really that's where the future's headed.
How do you see healthcare institutions and the paratransit or transit agencies collaborating?
A healthcare provider might be looking to say, for this population that we are looking to make sure that they're the most vulnerable, they are most susceptible, how do we get them to access food and other resources that would keep them healthy and most active in the community? That's paratransit. And then for medical appointments, or they need to come in for dialysis or chemo, how do we get them a wheelchair van or a stretcher vehicle that could get them to that care that needs to be provided? Traditional healthcare providers looking to tap into all of these resources so that they can maximize the outcomes. And I think they're also looking at how is transportation affecting the outcome? So for a population that is being served, we know that by offering rides to them, it results in an improvement in lifestyle and thus outcomes. How do we begin to track that? And again, with the shifting landscape of healthcare, as many of the healthcare providers are at risk based on these outcomes, they're going to need that insight and access in order to improve the overall care delivery model that is in place in the community.
The incentives have completely changed over the years. They're initially, as I said, the paratransit was a outgrowth of this mandate, forward-thinking ADA mandate, but forward-thinking agencies pre-ADA had offered what they called elderly and handicapped programs. We were a pioneer in providing this service pre-ADA and after ADA. Later, many of the healthcare institutions and nonprofit organizations started to push a lot of their own riders, their own patients, into the ADA programs in order to take advantage of that transportation service that was funded by state and federal funds rather than their own funds. When I say the incentives have changed from a healthcare institution perspective, and this is why your focus on outcomes is so important, is that it used to be that everybody wanted the length of stay. They wanted patients in the hospital. They wanted them in the healthcare institution. They got rewarded for that. Today, we see so much more outpatient treatment, outpatient services, that transportation is the key link. And I think there's a opportunity to combine many of these activities and improve the service for the patients and the institutions alike.